From cutthroat pioneers of the early oil industry to Machiavellian social engineers and geopolitical schemers, the oligarchs have come a long way since the days of Devil Bill's snake oil cure-alls. But his use of every form of deception and trickery to swindle the public informed how John Dee and the rest of the oligarchs built up their business interests. As the 20th century drew to a close, it was obvious that for the powerful cartel that built the oil industry, the Rockefellers, the Rothschilds, the British and Dutch royal families, it was no longer about oil, if it ever really was. The takeover of education, of medicine, of the monetary system, of the food supply itself, showed that the aim was much greater than a mere oil monopoly. It was the quest to monopolize all aspects of life, to erect the perfect system of control over every aspect of society, every sector from which any threat of competition to their power could emerge. They had been remarkably, almost unbelievably successful. From oil well to gas pump, farm to fork, hospital to pharmaceutical, drill rig to dollar bill, there was almost no aspect of society that was not under their control. But the oligarchs are not done yet. Their next project, launched in the late 20th century, is almost too ambitious to be comprehended. It is not about oil. It is not about money. It is about the monopolization of life itself. They have spent decades preparing the path for this takeover and marshaled their mind-boggling resources in service of the task. And the vast majority of the world's population, still playing the shell game that the oligarchs perfected and abandoned long ago, are about to fall right into their hands, yet again.
Ladies and gentlemen, the battle against climate change is surely the most defining and pivotal challenge of our times. Even in a world full of daunting perils and crises, it is hard to imagine anything that poses a greater challenge and opportunity for humanity.
The negative impact of population growth on all of our planetary ecosystems is becoming appallingly evident.
The science is unequivocally true, and that there is a price to carbon in their future.
What do you see as the biggest challenges in conservation?
The growing human population. Because if where we are, there's nothing else.
We have to start spending money, fast on the solutions that we have in hand to try and help these countries which are already seeing the effects of climate change today and seeing the effects of our consumption, basically.
David Rothschild, thank you so much for joining us here on Bloomberg.
Down in Pennsylvania, there is plenty oil, they say. Petroleum, petroleum, we must all have some. The oily fields.